everyone, welcome back to another video of electronic device. In this video, we are going to discuss about LED, light emitting diode. It's a very familiar and popular component in electronics field. How does it work? Let's see into that. And in the first module, we have discuss about indirect and direct semiconductors. Right. In that time, I told indirect semiconductor when excited electron coming back from the excitation state to stable state, it releases photon. That is the working principle of light emitting diode. Okay. I just want to refresh and give some more details about the light emitting diode here. It will be short video anyway. When an electron hole pairs are generated, it may be it is because of external source we applied, and the carriers are excited into higher impurity levels, that means higher energy level. Okay. And electron, we know the electrons are always try to come back into stable state. Okay, they will not be sustain long time in excitation state. It will come back by releasing energy. If the material is material characteristic is a direct semiconductor, a direct semiconductor, it will release the energy in terms of photons. Okay. From the level they fall to their equilibrium state, a light can be given off by the material. That light is actually used as source of light basically. Many semiconductor are well suited for light emission, particularly the compound semiconductor with a direct band gap. We know what is direct band gap. I'm not taking again the same concept in this video. Okay. So general property of the light emission is called luminescence. So compound semiconductors are very well known for luminescence. The same thing I'm telling here, the injection electroluminescence is the that effect. Basically, if we are injecting energy from externally and our carriers are got excited and move to impurity, higher impurity level, I mean higher energy level, and coming back to the equilibrium state by releasing light is basically injection electroluminescence. Okay, please remember this term, nothing else is there in this topic. And see, the color of LED purely depends on the frequency of working, right? The frequency of the photon governed by a band gap. So different semiconductor having different energy band gap. It depends on the energy band gap, it releases photons with a different color. And you can see that spectrum here, it's starting from infrared to ultraviolet. Okay, so this is all the combination of semiconductor. Okay, gallium arsenide is there very near to visible light, and infrared is germanium and silicon. We know this is indirect band gap semiconductor, it releases infrared. So it's exciting from ultraviolet to infrared, basically 3.4 electron volt band gap causes ultraviolet light, and 0.18 electron gap causes infrared light. Okay, so visible light somewhere here near to 2 electron volt to just after 3 electron volt. If any semiconductor possesses that energy band gap, it releases a visible light, a red green, red yellow, green blue, violet. It's at this is actually spectrum of that. Okay, so very important metric is quantum efficiency, that is Itanek external. It actually says how much electrical input power it's taking and how much light it's giving back. The ratio of that is basically give the efficiency, and it can be calculated using this expression. Okay, quantum efficiency is equal to internal radiative efficiency into extraction efficiency. The internal radiative efficiency basically gives by the quality of material, and is there any defect? Okay, is there a defect? And if one electron is excited from equilibrium energy band to some other impurity level, and it may come back to some internal impurity energy level, and it may hold for some time, and the electron may undergo thermal excitation again, is go back to the conduction band, it releases. So there may be some internal energy band where electron can hold. So depends on that, we can say that internal radiative efficiency and the extraction efficiency also. Okay, that's all about LED. It's very popular device which emits photon, and this emitting photon purely depends on that carrier excitation from lower energy band to, I mean, stable energy band to unstable energy band. Electron not sustain that particular energy band for long time, definitely come back by releasing the excited energy. That energy can be released, okay, if it is indirect semiconductor, that energy may release in terms of heat at the lattice of semiconductor atom, and if it is a direct semiconductor, it releases the energy in terms of photon. Okay, so that's about the LED light emitting diode. So we have completed almost all syllabus recommended photoelectronic devices. We started from photo diode, and come next to say solar panel, I mean solar cell, next to photo detector, PN diode, photo detector, and finally light emitting diode. Okay, thank you guys.